Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Our topic today is unlikely candidate to likely witness. Unlikely candidate to likely witness. Can anything good come from Nazareth? Well, this was a famous question, we know, asked by one of the men later to become a disciple of Jesus. This was a loaded question with a connotation that was derogatory. It was not positive. The question was asked by Nathanael at a time when the forerunner to Jesus Christ, John the Baptist, was going around testifying about the coming of the Messiah. We're looking today at John chapter 1, and this story starts from verse 6, running to verse 18. So John was preaching a message to the people about the need for repentance and appealing to them to prepare themselves. Down in verses 19 and 20, many thought that John the Baptist was the Messiah, and the local religious leaders questioned him, but he dispelled that. He insisted in verse 32 of chapter 1 of the book of John that he had seen the Messiah in the form of the Holy Spirit on someone else, Jesus, and that Jesus was identical to God the Father. He was, in fact, God's son. So John the Baptist instructed two of his followers, Andrew and John, the author of the fourth book of the Gospels, John, to follow this Jesus. Andrew, now convinced, started to recruit other followers and brought his brother Simon, whom Jesus renamed Peter. Jesus himself called Philip, and Philip found Nathanael. And this is where this famous question comes in. Nathanael was a skeptic, and he was not afraid to be analytical and ask questions. John chapter 1, verses 45 to 46 says, Philip findeth Nathanael, and saith unto him, We have found him, of whom Moses in the law and the prophets did write, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. And Nathanael said unto him, Can there any good thing come out of Nazareth? Philip saith unto him, Come and see. History recorded that Nazareth was one of the lowliest places on earth, and nothing good came out of it. Does your family history, does your past, your track record give people reason to say nothing good will become of you? And if that has already been said, how determined are we to prove them wrong? Especially now that we know that Jesus came out of Nazareth and he was the epitome of good. He was good personified. He did not represent the bad from which he came. He defied the odds and continued to prove that he would not be categorized as a good-for-nothing because of where he was born. Are we going to be drunkards and drug addicts, thieves and vagabonds because our foreparents were known to be such? Men, are you going to sleep around because our enslaved forefathers were made to do that so the slave masters can have more slaves to work for them? Absolutely not. When you know better, you do better. We are now Christians, changed. We are a new creation, born again, saved, sanctified, washed in the blood of the Lamb. 1 Corinthians 1, 26 to 31 says, Take a good look, friends, at who you were when you got called into this life. I don't see many of the brightest and the best among you, not many influential, not many from high society families. Isn't it obvious that God deliberately chose men and women that the culture overlooks and exploits and abuses? Chose these nobodies to expose the hollow pretensions of the somebodies? That makes it quite clear that none of you can get by with blowing your own horn before God. Everything that we have, right thinking and right living, a clean slate and a fresh start, comes from God by way of Jesus Christ. That's why we have the saying, if you're going to blow a horn, blow a trumpet for God. So back to the book of John chapter 1. Do we see Jesus portraying that as he chose the first five and later the rest of his 12 disciples? They were unlikely to be chosen as his followers because some of them were known to be foul-mouthed fishermen. Then throughout Jesus' ministry, as one preacher put it, he had unlikely women who traveled with him and were the first to proclaim the resurrection. He had unlikely lepers, blind and sick, whom he healed. He had an unlikely Samaritan woman who was the first evangelist in the scriptures. Can you place yourself in that category? I can say Jesus took me. My family was not rich. We didn't have a popular surname. I was neglected and abused. I did not go to university. Many of you didn't even know where Montserrat, my home country, is. But Jesus took this unlikely candidate and saved me, redeemed me, healed me, and not only rescued me, but now gives me the privilege of leading out in this ministry that unites and enriches so many people from around the world on a daily basis. Can anything good come from my single mother? Can anything good come from Montserrat? Now you can ask yourself that question, personalize it. And I'm sure that we all are saying, hallelujah, what a savior, and thanking him daily for choosing us, unlikely candidates though we were to the world. We are now witnesses for him. We were not discarded by God. Even though the world saw us as unlikely candidates, we are now witnesses for God. Glory to his name. Can anything good come from Nazareth? Of course, Nazareth was the birthplace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because of his birth, his life, his death, and his resurrection, Nazareth, which once was frowned on, is now one of the pilgrimage centers in the world, a place of hope and honor. So are you still feeling unqualified, unworthy, or unable to tell somebody about this Jesus? Are you allowing people to dictate to you that you are not qualified to do what God has called you to do? Well, I've been there. Notice I'm speaking in the past tense. Family, I looked back at the devotion topics over the past 2 weeks, and they were forerunners to this exhortation today. We didn't know it, but God did. Thanks be to God. No more darkness, Bishop Ambrose. Hallelujah. Pastor Irma spoke to us about a brand new me, and we are chosen by God. Elder Jerry reminded us that the foundation has been dug, and as we go forth, remember God said, "Fear not, because I am with you." If we are still unsure that we can represent Jesus, Evangelist Esther said, "You're right, we cannot look good on the outside and be empty on the inside." So ask God to wash us. Hallelujah. Pastor Monique emphasized, yes, we can, and we should ask God to empty me of me, so that, as Pastor Carlton said, we can be stretched to serve him more. And then, of course, we have to remember those who branded us as unworthy, Pastor Veronica, and walk in forgiveness. Glory to God. Family, check it out. God has always used highly unlikely people in highly unlikely places to do highly unlikely things. Remember Noah, Rahab, Esther, Joseph, David, Paul, me, Angela, and you can put your name there too. But remember now, we boast not in ourselves. It is God who must get the glory. Amen? Because he continues to be good to us, so we remain humble, we remain grateful, we remain united, and we remain committed and dedicated to doing what God has called us to do, and that is to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ throughout the world. And let us do so as unto God, for his glory, as we are not or no longer unlikely candidates, but we are now likely witnesses for him. Glory to God.